excited. It's been a lot of fun. It's my very first fashion week, so I'm enjoying myself.
I think the most important thing is to be less concerned about starting your own design house and really going to work for someone that you admire, whose work you love.
13 years ago, you had a vision. Tell us that vision.
The vision was that there were several students who were interested in not only singing the gospel music, but singing, period.
It showcases for the world how important FIT is to the industry and the great respect that clearly people have for us and the esteem in which we're held.
Hey, what's up, FIT? It's time for another exciting episode of Real Talk with Zadrian Smith. And today I have a very special, exciting guest with me, the chair of the fashion design department, one of the strongest departments on our campus, Professor Colette Wong. Professor,
hello.
Thank you so much for joining us today.
My pleasure.
Really excited to talk about the fashion design department and how you guys, you know, the FIT was founded on the fashion design department. Is that
absolutely
correct?
Right.
Tell us now, you guys are the strongest department. How do you balance that schedule with so many students wanting to get in, selecting the students that do get in, and then priming them and then preparing them for the real world?
Well, that's an interesting question and a lot of questions. So we'll start at the beginning.
Okay.
Because basically, fashion design is the largest department of the design school, and we really are proud of the fact that we really try to recruit students that have a passion for fashion. So we get a lot of applicants. We get over 2,500 applicants.
Wow. How many students do you take in?
We take in 9 sections in the fall alone.
Okay.
So that's at the associate level.
Okay.
And then we take 6 sections of the BFA program. So you're talking 350 students for the 2-year program, and then another 2 sections of 1 year, so another 50 students.
Wow.
In the 1-year program, and then we take another 150 in for the BFA.
Now, what are you looking for when you're accepting the students into the school? Like, does FIT have an aesthetic that they look for in the students, or what do you, when you
we look for the aesthetics of students that have some raw talent.
Mm-hmm.
We want to see that raw talent, that passion for fashion, an understanding of what fashion is really about, because it's not about making a pretty picture on a piece of paper. It's much more than that. And we need to separate the ones that feel that fashion is making pretty pictures,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
and the ones that really want to show you their dimension.
FIT definitely has a large international student base and a lot of international,
mm-hmm,
students in,
mm-hmm,
the fashion design major. What have you found over the years, just the difference between an international student applying for the program and a student from the U.S. applying for the program?
It's very good, yes. It's true, there is a difference, because we have a lot of students that come from all over the world that really have already done some type of fashion schooling.
Mm-hmm.
So they come to us already with a base knowledge of fashion and educated in fashion. So we find that there is a little bit of a difference between an international student that wants to further their understanding of fashion, and they feel that FIT is the one they need to get into, the one they need to get a degree from to make them truly successful.
So what's the advantage of students coming to FIT over going to like a Parsons or a FITM or an RIDM? What does FIT have that these other schools don't have?
Well, I really think that we are really a gem, because we offer such an elaborate, in-depth study of fashion. And because we're a state school, we're very reasonable.
So what words of advice would you give to the fashion design students who might feel that they can't bear it or it's just too much for them?
Well, I think there's really good avenues for students to get servicing. And the first thing I always stress is time management skills. Students that come in here as freshmen, they have to understand they're going to be under a lot of stress and pressure, because they're finding out exactly what fashion design is about. And time management skills, very important. You have to really realize that you can't get everything done at once, and you have to space it out.
Mm-hmm.
With that, I feel if students are starting to feel like they're floundering and they're not sure how they're going to succeed, they really need to first come to the professors. Then if they can't get the answers, they should come to the department and talk to the assistant chair, student related, or myself. and also because the school is so good about servicing students. Let's face it, they can go to counseling, they can get tutoring. We offer all kinds of skills, and we are not shy about explaining that to students. Mm-hmm.
Definitely. Well, I also want to talk to you a little bit about, you know, in regards to, you said some of the classes that you decide to take away or to add on. I also know that one of the questions that I've specifically asked to ask you is, why don't we have a costume design department? Especially, you know, we're in New York, Broadway is everywhere, all the great shows. Mm-hmm. Why is it that we don't have costume design as a major for the fashion design department?
Well, you know, basically because we started out as a fashion school, mm-hmm. I think that was the main thing. And the other part is there are such great programs, costume programs out there, and they really start at a master's program.
Okay.
They don't really start as an undergrad.
Okay.
So going through our fashion design program and then going into costumes is really the way most of the successful costume designers come.
Do you think that fashion design students, should they go on to study on the graduate level? We were talking about the costume design earlier. Is that an important avenue for fashion design students to take?
We haven't really considered it that important. Mm-hmm. We feel that after 4 years, get out there and do
get
it.
The
you know, there's been discussion about it, but I really think that our industry is such that it's so competitive and it changes so quickly that I think 4 years is good.
Four years is good.
Get out there and do your thing.
I think experience is probably the best thing to do, just to get out there in the field, mm-hmm. and have that experience, mm-hmm. and learn from it.
Yes, and I think that students need to understand when you graduate and you try this part of your career or your goal, you may change your mind. Mm-hmm. You may end up going in another direction. And I'm feeling that most students will have, once they graduate, they will have anywhere between 2, 4, 6 careers in their lifetime.
Wow.
Much different than my parents or mm-hmm, so mm-hmm. forth.
Have the one job for such
yes,
a, they just go into
exactly.
so many different careers. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about the garment district. Now, mm-hmm. we know that there's been a lot of issues going back and forth. Actually, Nanette Lepore, an FIT alumni, mm-hmm. has really been a strong force behind it, being an advocate to make sure that we don't lose the garment district.
Absolutely.
I don't think a lot of students know that, you know, the garment district is possibly going to be fading away. Can you just stress the importance of this haven of fashion for our industry?
I think the students should be the first call of getting out there and saying, what's going on? You know, basically all the schools, you know, Parsons, Pratt, a lot of the schools depend on the industry being here. I mean, let's face it, that's what everything's built off of.
Mm-hmm.
This city, you know, 8th Avenue, 7th Avenue, Madison Avenue, and it would be just a darn shame that the area that we know of as the Fabric District, the all of the studios and so forth, you know, if they go away, what are we going to do? What is this program going to do?
For more information on how you can get involved in Saving the Garment Center, visit SaveTheGarmentCenter.org.